Yes, sir. No, nah, you all good, bro.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup, and we are all set to go, as it'll be the Armadillos of San Antonio taking on the Green Bay Packers. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. Start on the ground here on first down. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to me.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
First and 10, and he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a hole. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down. So, Charles, you know, offensively, this group really playing at a high level, 7-0. And we're still a long ways from discussing a potential unbeaten season, I think, but to use a golf expression, no blemishes on the card, at least to this point. There he goes, right side. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. So that about the shortest pass a quarterback can make, but it winds up going for a bundle.
Yeah, let's face it, in the stats, It sure looks like a heck of a throw, doesn't it? It's almost like in baseball when you give that little Texas leaguer that turns into a double. You would think that you hit it off the wall. Big time play for him on a short little pass.
Back to throw now on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Here's second and 10. Lamb will go in motion. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Packer pressure, and down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. They'll set up the throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down.
There's another example of what defensive coaches constantly preach, not allowing any run after the catch. They give up a few more yards than they wanted to, but they were able to get him down quickly and force a fourth down.
He'll look to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. Touchdown! A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Armadillo's decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he returns this to the 22. To the ground here in Brown. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. The Packers at 5-3 now on the year. They coming off the loss last time out, but they've been playing better than 500 ball the last couple of months, CD. 5 wins in their last 8 games.
And last week, not only on the scoreboard, but I saw it on tape as well. Definitely not one of their finer performances because they were outclassed pretty much right from the start. So I think there'll be a renewed emphasis on trying to be a little better out of the gate in this one so they don't fall into a big hole.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. 14 yards that time, but a first down on the keeper. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
See, we know this defense prepared all week for this. That's a big, throw that bitch. That shit's so ass, bro.
And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. Three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
On first and ten, here's Brown. And a loose fumble. And one of the linebackers has got it. And his guys are going to take over at the 31.
Yeah, who likes those?
Partner, on my spot sheets, I highlighted turnover margin because we remember they turned it over four times last week. So another one here in the first quarter.
Waiting on it all the time. God fuck that cheese, boy.
And it's not something they even imagine because the amount of time that we know that they spend in practice talking about
that tail off, boy.
Pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play a leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Intended target, but it's going to be second down. You look at this Packers defense. They come into this one way down at number 23 against the run of the NFL.
And this group talks all the time about wanting to be better, getting stronger against the run. And to me, it all starts up front. You've got to win the line of scrimmage in order to play against the run very well.
On play action, they'll throw. Escaping the pressure right. He finds his man complete. It's Oliver. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Throw now on first down. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line. He's sacked. It looks like a loss of right around 11 there on first down to set him back on second. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. And they'll send the slot in motion left. To throw. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So that one a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that could be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Able to hit his target, Lamb. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Fake. They'll look to throw. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what would turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Second quarter now. San Antonio in possession. as they've got it with a fourth down coming up. And the first play will be a field goal try. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. So 3 points left on the table thanks to a great play there on special teams. They just couldn't protect long enough, Charles, to get that kick away.
Yeah, special teams coaches aren't just simply there to applaud, right? And they're not just there to encourage. They're there to find weaknesses where you can go block the kick. Give them big credit for that one. Good scouting, and they executed it well.
Oh, felt like that move deserved more than he got there. A gain of 2.
What up, my boy? Yeah, yo.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well.
Yeah, yo. This nigga right here been fucking messaging me to play for like fucking 10 days now on my dick, bro. Yeah, it's clown ass. Old ass bitch. Shit, the other one they don't give a fuck about. Nigga Ben said talking about this was his first priority. He Ben said that.
Back to throw here.
Inbounds.
It's Pearson. And he's gonna have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Oh, facts. Yes. You got to stay home.
Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Definitely not doing that, bud. We on that dumb shit. I forgot you the RPO nigga.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Flush down right, and he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
Trying to keep the drive going.
This shit right here be making me so mad, bro. This stupid ass play cool down shit. Starting to think niggas in this bitch cheating because every time I play on these niggas, they blocking the field goal, bro.
They gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
Just 4 yards, and it's second down. Now they'll audible to something else. Here's Brown on second down.
Let's get that X factor off right there, my boy.
Tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
Sometimes being a linebacker in the middle of the field is kind of like being a doctor on the field. You got to make the right diagnosis. Here he correctly sends his run and shoots through to make the play in the backfield.
Let's go now. In search of 8 yards on.
You only get one play with that. I don't allow that too much.
Drive, 2 for 2. Looking to throw.
Trayvon. We need those. He's a bot. We need those.
As expected, he's gone to him several times in this game, but that's the first time one has slipped from his grasp.
I'll bet he goes back to him, though. He's an excellent player.
And his kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the two-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a three and out, there could be enough time on the clock that they can get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board.
A return from the middle of the end zone, and he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they, as mentioned, unbeaten to this point in the year, but you think this game
is their toughest test. Let's sit you running, but they're not going
to
help you, bro.
This is another team leading its division with an eye on making a Super Bowl run, so this game is crucial.
Here's second and eight. He's going to sling this deep downfield. They've got his man complete.
As soon as he got that step, I knew he was dead. I really could have ran that. I really could have ran straight, bro.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. A great effort there. His 12th rushing touchdown on the year. As his guys are able.
And I was trying to score fast because I want this nigga on fucking watch him because I want his ass on offense so he can give me the ball. I don't know why niggas think this team is still the same, but this team is not the same, bro. These niggas are playing so different, bro. Modes, is that my nigga that he got right there? No, Terrence got my nigga Modes. The DB. I'm not mistaken. Need to keep running fucking under center shit. He is a fucking old ass bot, bro. No, you can't do that. Put back. Stay inbounds, pussy. Oh my god. You see the fake shit they be giving these niggas, bro? My nigga swarming right there. Come on now. Can't do that. No, sir. Get in there, Mike. See what I'm saying, cuz I need him on offense, bro. I need him on offense, bro.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit, but the worst thing he can do is what you're seeing right now, showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got to gather himself, compose himself, and keep fighting.
Niggas not believing in niggas not believing in this shit. They think this shit fluke, cuz. It's not fluke, I promise you. This team is really like that, bro. It's not fluke. I might just get his bitch to CD, to be honest, bro. Get CD juking the guy out of his shoes, bro. Inaccurate is actually crazy right there, bro. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt, and the Packers D comes up with a big stop.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and eight. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock. But what that?
Ready for the second half. 14-3 our scores. We are back underway on EA Sports. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end
tell
zone.
Tell them what they're trying to get on, bro.
He's taken down right at the 20. Set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so.
He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. A solid stiff arm. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
And they're going to speed things up here. Here's a second and seven. Complete. Touchdown. A great play there. With second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Armadillos are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Jay, I don't even think niggas don't realize, boy, I got the number one defense in the league for a reason, boy. These boys are playing their ass off. Into my number one all the way across the board in this bitch.
Drive underway. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Second and 10. Now back to throw. But he's got his target.
And now look at that.
Give me that shit, boy. Oh.
Hold on to that tater, boy. Boy, I got that bit fumbling and bumbling.
Now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10, right back to Brown. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll drop the throw. Throw left side complete. That's Brown. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. 23 yards, the final tally.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well, like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12.
The ball,
feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. He'll try again, and he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Packers are able to cut into that deficit.
And that's a step in the right direction. This had the feeling of one of those turning point kind of drives. If you come up empty there, it could be a long road back. But they persevered and hung around, and they closed the gap here in the third quarter with their first touchdown of the game.
Carlson's extra point up and good, and he makes the score 21-10. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of 1st downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
They lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Yes, indeed. That play there, that reminds me of some of the guys that I played with to have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot. week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team would say, hey, yeah, we called him the disruptor. And that's carrying forward again.
Makes sense, doesn't it?
He's going to air one out. But it's caught inside the 20. It's a big play there on third down. 57 yards.
Well, that was a pretty good time for his first catch of the ball game, and it turned into a huge play as well. He's certainly not been a central part of this passing game so far in this one, but he made his presence felt there. A big pickup on third down.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They'll look to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown. As his
guys have he don't got a fucking clue what the hell is going on, bro.
And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, if you have him, you use him because he's a guy who's going to win just about every time. I don't care what the coverage is.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
Ball out. Damn, Tariq. You never get fumbles, man.
In this position, trying to get back into the game.
Boy, been a long ass day, boy. Boy, been a long ass fucking week.
The Green Bay offense at the line. Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them.
Long ass fucking week, man.
Keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played.
16 is dropping. I knew he had
done. Taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
And he'll have this pass.
You got to actually throw the ball down the field, bro. You're not just finna break out off a drag. I'm not finna allow that, bro. That's all you're good for, throwing the ball fucking 2 yards down the field. Not finna allow you to score off a drag, bro. You just like throwing shit underneath. See, you can do that all the way down the field and waste all the clock. Go right ahead.
It's gotta start with this drive. Down three scores, they need to start making
that nigga nickel and diamond like he up by 30, bro.
Pick up good yardage and a first down.
Back to throw now on first down.
Yes, sir. Get in there, Tosh. Oh, that's a lollipop. That's true. Look at this shit, man. Jake, he don't know what's going on, bro. I'm telling you, cuz he don't know what the fuck is going on, bro.
They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
And this time I'm finna send that thing get him this time. Man, you seen the animation? He just got to stay on his feet, bro. That is so fucking stupid, man. That is dumb as hell, bro. Game stupid as fuck. Damn, I'm trying to crack this nigga.
Throw again. And he's got it.
Like, Tyree, why didn't you just play that, man? Then they so the shit so bogus, bro. I literally can just run man on this nigga the whole game. All he wanna do is throw the ball to the fucking running back, bro. Just fucking run man, bro. Solve all your problems. He's fucking terrible. Oh, he out. This nigga a clown. I just punished the life out of him, bro. Right choice by result, but a little bit surprising because now with touchbacks coming back to the 25 instead of the 20, when guys fielded that deep in the end zone, I think most coaches want them to take a knee. Yeah, it's resulted in more kneel downs. Not right there. A try here for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. Now this is going to be returned from the back line of the end zone. Watch it. Fuck. Taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this. All right, now it's time to go nickel, bro. I need them demons on that D-line on the field, bro. I need all four X-Factor superstars on the field, bro. Time to box shit, bro. Let's do it. Trying to box shit, let's do it. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight. He's got a how? Like, why is he getting beat? It's a big play there for Green Bay. 75 yards. To get back in this ball game, big plays are going to be necessary. And here's one right on cue. Coming up with three scores here in the fourth is not going to be an easy task. But that's good work there to bite off a chunk of yards. Now a give left side, Brown with it. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. You know, when this offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow. And this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Brown once more, and he'll be stopped up short as the tackle is made at about the 3. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized. Scrimmage back at the 6. And a field goal obviously means nothing here. They're going to go ahead and go for it on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. Yeah, that shit finito for you, dude. I ain't going to cap to you. That bitch over with. And as a result, possession switches hands. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. Running back ain't even been punishing you, nigga. First down, that brings up 2nd and 5. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
I really wanted that halfback win, but... here's what it is. Okay, ready. Now 2nd and 5.
Go. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to
What type of tackle did y'all just allow this body ass nigga to make, bro? Of course, bro. It never fails, bro.
Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Brown.
Of course.
Extra point up and good, and that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. The kickoff team on
11.
The field now as they will send this one away.
I'm advise you to stop kicking the ball out to me, bro. I can return this bitch anytime I want to be honest.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
How many plays I got? 6 fucking plays, bro. Yeah. I really just want to bomb his ass, bro.
The offense now.
Fuck it, let's work the clock, I guess.
Well, don't look now, but they've got
that was perfect. That was perfect shield. Perfect shield. That was exactly what I needed you to do. You see y'all that room over there. Let's start getting dicey. It's about to start getting dicey. That clock running. You thought, but stay right there in that defense, right there that you in. Excellent pocket. Actually, fucking fantastical. What you gonna do when that clock get the ticking, my nigga? What are we doing right now, Madden? Like, what in the fuck was that? You tried to hold me then, bro. I ain't even gonna lie to you. You tried to hold me then.
Now a second and 10. On play action, they'll throw. Got a man, it's caught inside.
That linebacker out of coverage, man. What are you doing? What are you doing? Get him from back there. What are you doing?
This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
Get him from back there. What are you doing?
The second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this this fourth quarter. The chain gang hustling to catch up.
CD, let's get to the promised land.
Lamb will go in motion. He'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. And he's just going to run right into that big old
defense. Get that timeout, man.
That play going nowhere.
There we go.
The Packers going to burn their third and final timeout.
Get that timeout, nigga.
So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. Play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he wisely will throw that one away. And it's Mark play there.
This nigga do know anything right here is good for me, right? Literally anything. We have 2.5 minutes. You're not going to score on me fast, bro.
Will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. Fights off the tackle at the 20. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Here's first and 10.
Get the ball up. He's holding.
So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time.
You can't do that. He's holding.
What you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
They'll set up a throw.
That's a box, nigga.
That should do it. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. That is now seven. Seven interceptions between last week and this week. Three in this game, 4 weeks ago.
Stretch him out for thinking he can fucking play with you, bro. Stretch him. Lay him flat on his fucking stomach. That's a good ass pass, boy.
A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
As soon as he leaked out and began his route, someone on the defensive side broke with him and arrived just in time to separate him from another reception.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw here. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Oliver. Give him 19 on the play, but they will still come up a bit short. And now it's fourth down. With that last completion, CD's now over 400 yards passing in the game. And quite a few of those have come via some pretty big strikes downfield. Certainly not afraid to challenge this secondary, and it's been successful.
I like your observation there, partner, because I agree. This is
torching a secondary any week is evidenced by their combined stat line here. And in the time we have remaining, wouldn't shock me at all to see them take another deep shot.
It's a pickup of two, and that's good enough to just about write a finish to this one. Now. So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational.
Nigga begging me to play just to lose, bro. Begging me, literally begging me, bro. 2 days straight begging me to get beat.
So this crowd will not go home happy. It's a
begging me and rushing me like you just finna beat me by 100 or something, nigga.
Big second half that put this one on ice.
Fuck out of here, clown.
Whatever was said at halftime, obviously hit home.
405 passing yards. My God. Nigga slanging that iron on his ass, man. Okay, fuck with me, dude. I'm telling y'all, man, this team different, bro. This team different. They're not the same. They're not the same, bro. Turnover after fucking turnover, nigga. I get it, 3, 2, 5, 12 months, 24/7, got a year. How is not boy not first, bro? And he got the record.